Hi, it's me. During World War II, Japan's military struck at targets in Canada. This included intercontinental firebombing balloons which landed in Canada, a submarine torpedoing a Canadian lumber schooner near Cape Flattery, and a submarine shelling the Canadian radio and compass station at Estevan Point on Vancouver Island. Depth charge bombers monitored the west coast of Canada for part of World War II. On February 10, 1945, Cansole 11007 took off from Tofino and headed for Cole Harbour, after getting repairs done to its port engine. Pilot Ron Scholes led a crew of 10 men and one woman. The plane's armaments included four 250-pound depth charges and automatic weapons. The flight launched at 2300 hours and was about 12 days after the full moon, and the town of Tofino was quite small at the time, so it was very dark out. This Cansole had engine trouble during its mission, turned to go back to Tofino, but crashed into Radar Hill. Most of the remains of the planes are still there, and a number of hikers like to make the hike up to that bomber site. The trail is about 1.6 kilometers, about a mile. The hike's moderate, but there are parts where you're walking along logs and twigs and roots through swampish areas, so I advise good hiking boots. That being said, the same time we did the hike in 2014, a group of hikers did it barefoot, so your choice. I suggest bringing some standard items for a short hike, but the hike isn't that long, so I wouldn't recommend a backpack and a tent or anything like that. The first part of the hike is pretty straightforward. Partway along the hike, there's an old building, which I suspect will be where the final holdout of mankind is when we have the last stand against the zombies. Past the building, the hike isn't that well marked off, but when we hiked there in 2014, some hikers had laid ropes along the trail as a guide. Even without the bomber, I found the hike worth taking. Some of the forest looks very similar to the bog trail, which is about 14 kilometers from Radar Hill, which is also a recommended hike, but it's a lot easier. It's like a boardwalk trail. So up near the downed airplane, near Tofino in September 2014. Bit of a hike to make it up here, but it was interesting. Still more mud to walk through, but so you're a little closer to the plane. You can see the tail section up here. And there's lots of trees in the way, making it hard to see the entire plane, but I'll do a scroll past. Maybe when we get up higher, I'll get a better view. So this is right up beside the plane. You can see where the wing was torn off up there. Okay, I'm going to try and have a look inside. Isaac, stay. What we look like. I didn't bring any good camera lights. Here's a view from up above the plane. There's the front and then a view inside. And a bit of a view from up above. Please treat both the trail and the historical site with respect.
I'm not completely covered, so part of me is going to freeze solid while I'm in the water. With this part of me down here. We don't want the current to pull us over towards those rocks over there, so we're moving further over into the middle of Cox Bay.